has worked with a wide variety of both rural and urban communities, regional organizations, and even states, helping with comprehensive strategic plans and marketing implementation efforts. So please help me in welcoming Allison Larson.
You may never have heard of me or Chabon Concepts, my primary employer, nor Competitive Ready, because it's a new initiative for competitiveness. So, insight selection, you're probably familiar with different parts or maybe this whole continuum of the site selection process. The economic developer is not always involved in that process. But I'm going to show you today how you might be more involved than you know. Not uncommon to think of the site selection process as a funnel, and the key is you really want to stay in the race. You want to be that last company that pops out that's still standing. And to do that, it takes a balance of competing interests. In fact, I was really impressed with Jim Newsom's presentation earlier because supply chain is one of the top trends. And a lot of that also has to do with, if you look at like social media in the sense that that allows for more collaboration for innovation, it's even harder for the companies to stay ahead of the curve. But for workers that are coming globally because of their talents to work for your local employers, and as economic developers, I'm going to believe you want to put your local folks to work before anyone moving here. This happened to be a comparative advantage, so you can see some are very high compared to other areas. So if it's an aerospace company doing a very specific type of work, they can access this network of professionals, talented industry-specific folks, and bring them into this project before the training starts. Thank you very much, and I'm around if you have any questions.